My name is Bao, and I'm a senior communications major here at Upstate. You've already heard that before. And this is my book narrative. So my story begins in a refugee camp located in northern Thailand called Van Dinai, where I was born. And as a baby, I fell off a bed. My mom told me that my sister had taken me to visit our cousins and had placed me on a bed, and they were jumping on the bed and I fell off. And they said I fell off and landed on my left side. And because there were no medical facilities or hospitals around, I didn't get the medical attention that I needed at the time. So I guess growing up, as I grew up, my mom started to notice, differences or, and so, but there was nothing that she could do. It wasn't until my family moved to the States and settled in Wisconsin I was able to start going to medical facilities and hospitals, and they started testing me, running tests, and they found out that not only had I injured my left arm and my left foot, but I had also injured my brain. And so that started a whole series of therapy. I went to physical therapy, I did water aerobics, and I even was put in a foot brace to try to correct, because I walk with a limp, and I have, and I'm pretty much what you would consider club-footed. So they were trying to correct that growing up, but all that came to an end when my family moved to Massachusetts. And growing up, I was always treated differently, and so when our family moved to Massachusetts, I decided I didn't want to be treated, and I was a lot older, so I decided I didn't want to be treated differently. I didn't want to continue leaving classes or, going to water aerobics or physical therapy. So I tested out of, being considered special. And so it wasn't until my family moved to South Carolina that I discovered what I had been diagnosed with. And I was going through some medical records that my mom had kept stored away in one of her filing cabinets. The doctors had diagnosed me with cerebral palsy. And cerebral palsy is a brain disorder that affects mobility, balance, and posture. And there's two kinds. There's congenital, which pretty much is that you're born with it. It occurs before birth or during birth. And acquired, which results from brain injury or something like that. So mine is pretty much acquired cerebral palsy. And the CDC reports that 1 in 323 children have cerebral palsy. To me, cerebral palsy is more of a disability. I think they do consider it a disability. It's hard to talk about it, and so I have not really done research for myself, even though this is what I was diagnosed with. And so here are a few forms of cerebral palsy, and it's more, it happens more in children, And so there's ataxic cerebral palsy, dyskinetic, hypotonic. There's the mixed group where you can have all forms of it. Then there's spastic. I think I'm in the other and mixed group. I would fall under that. And pretty much spastic is that you, spastic is just, you know, just, I'm sorry, guys. It is pretty much the most,
You're doing great. Keep going.
The most common form, and I forget what spastic, but I also have dyskinetic, and that's pretty much involuntary movements. Spastic has to do with, but hypotonic is more the ragdoll, like you have like, I guess, like a troll. But, yeah. So my transformation, I would say that there's really no transformation as of yet. I still struggle with it. And I would say that it's still a work in progress. It's still open. And so, yeah, I encourage you guys to, if you guys are interested, to look into cerebral palsy. And if you guys, yeah. Thank you. Sorry.